The industry. So, why we are speaking about this industry from the long time? There is a use of this industry because based on this industry, we are going to convert a regular expression to NFA. So, what are the things we can calculate from the syntax tree? So, construct a DFA from regular expression, we construct it syntax tree and then compute four functions. One is called nullable, first position, last position, and follow position. Here, a very important thing we are going to do, that is regular expression to DFA. Still now, what we was doing? We used to do regular expression to NFA. Then we know how to convert NFA to DFA. So we had converted NFA to DFA. But this time, what we are going to do? We are going to convert regular expression directly to DFA. This is very interesting thing that we are not going to follow this step. We are not going to first convert to NFA then DFA. Simply we are converting regular expression directly to the DFA, right? So you see here we have our syntax tree here, nullable of node n. So it says the answer in yes or no. Nullable can be treated as a function. Okay, this function returns yes or no. That means whether that particular node n is nullable or not nullable. So is true for syntax tree node n if and only if the sub expression represented by n has epsilon in its language. Like if you see this, if this is your node n, it is nullable. Then nullable equal to yes. Here, nullable n equal to true. Okay. Now sub expression can be made null or the empty string, even though there may be other strings in the strings it can represent as well. Okay, so that means it is nullable, but it definitely it can also generate any other string of combination of A or B. This node N can give you only A, it can give you B, it can give you A, B and anything, right? Because this node N is given by regular expression A or B star, correct? So it can give you anything, but at the same time it is giving you epsilon. That is important for us. It is giving you epsilon. Okay, now what is first position? First position n is the set of position in the subtree rooted at n that correspond to the first symbol of the list of at least one string in the language of the sub expression rooted at n. That means if still you are treating this as node n, at this we forget about this part, forget about this part. Okay, you are at node n. At node n itself, what are the string you can generate? We can generate string like A, we can generate string B, we can generate A B, we can generate B A B, or whatever, any combination of A B. So at this point, at node N, what are the symbols you have which can come or which at the first position of the generated strings? The strings are going to be generated, possible strings. So what are the strings or what are the symbols can come at the first position? So here definitely you can see A can come at the first position or B can come at the first position. So at this point, if I ask you that first position of N, and N is this node, this is N, then you will say A and B. So this is the first position of N set. Okay. Now, last position of N, and it's again same thing. Last position of N is the set of position in the substring rooted at N that correspond to the last symbol at least one string in the language of the sub-expression that rooted at N. Again, if you're treating this as your N node, then you forget about this part. What sub-expression is rooted at N? This is the sub-expression rooted at N. Correct. So, what are the string you can generate at this point at N? What are the symbol can come at the last position? You can generate only A, you can generate only B, you can generate B, B, A, you can generate A, B, A, so on. And it can be ended B. So if you see, look at this string, starts with A and ends with A. So last position is A itself. Here, if you see, this ends with B, starts with also B. So last position of N here can be A or B. Now here is one problem. If you only write A or B, there is another A here, another B here. So which A or B are speaking about? So instead we write A or B, better we write the position numbers. So if we write one, then we can simply find out what it mean, what this one means. One means a position which is B. So it is just a pointer. Okay. So sorry, which is A. And position two we write, which is correspond to a B. Okay. So this is more accurate, without confusion you can write. So another thing we can find out here, follow position of P. For a position P in the set of position Q, the entire syntax tree says that there is some string X equal to A1, A2, AN in L of R hash, such that for some I, there is a way to explain the membership of X in L of R hash by matching AI to position P of the syntax tree and AI plus 1 to be position Q. So what does it mean? It means that if you are at a position, say 3, okay? If you are at a position 3, that means at 3, whatever this, when this position will appear, when you will have this node done, right? That means from this star node, it is going to give you A or B first star, and this position 3 means A, this position 3, this position 1, this position 2, right? So what is the follow position? That means after this position 3, which position can appear? Which position will get a chance to appear? See, after this, this B will come, right? This B is having position 4. So if I say follow position of 3, then the answer is simply 4. Only 4 is the position which can follow 3. Okay? Not 5. If you think about 5, 5 position, this is another B. This B is not following actually A, it is following this B, that is the position 4. Right? So it is very important to understand follow position. Okay. Now, consider the cat node N corresponding to expression this A or B star A, so sub expression I should say. So null level N is false, right? Because what we are here speaking about is about this node, right? This node gives you what? A or B whole star and A. So this node is nullable. No, because if you think about this node, it's this is its say left child. And which is definitely nullable, but this is the right child, and this is not nullable, right? So as this is not nullable and this is concatenation, now if you concatenate a null with anything, then it is definitely not null. So it is not nullable. Okay, so this is, so this node is not nullable. Okay, so this will nullable N will return you false. Since the node generates all string of A's and B's ending with, you know, ending in an A. So this thing. Okay. So does not generate epsilon in any case. Okay. So the start node below in the, sorry, it is nullable. You know, start, the star node below it is the star. Okay. So this is definitely nullable. It generates epsilon ln with all other string of A's and B's. I have already told you. Okay. Now, if you here, if you see first position of N, this is N. At this point, if the left side becomes null, then this A will be the first position, only string it will generate. That means this position 3 can be one of the chance or one of the option of first position. And in another case, if this is not generating null, the star is giving A or B whole plus, in that case, either A or B will become the first position. So one or two will get chance to be the first position. So first position of N is either one or two or three. So this is what here. Then last position of N, if you see in this case, this is node. Okay. So this A is always going to be concatenated with the outcome of the left child. So this is always get the chance to be the last position. Follow position of one. One means what? This is the one position. So who can follow this A? As there is, you know, it is A or B or star, it can generate A. So in that case, this A, this A is also having position number one, and this place is also in position number one. So position number one can follow the position number one itself, or it can generate A B. In that case, this B is position number two. Position number two. The position number two is following A, right? So position number two can follow the position number one, and if this, if you think about this left child, this whole left child is becoming epsilon, and this, you know, using this concatenation mode, this third position A third position A is concatenated, then it is going to generate only A, right? So, okay, with only A, and if it is this left child generating only A, okay, no B, only A it is generating, and it is concatenated with the third position A, so this is first position A, and then concatenated with the A, which is on third position. In that case, this third position is following this first position. So this three is coming here in this set. Understand? So how this polar position is calculated? Now, computing nullable first position and last position, the whole rule set is, you know, put it in a tabular manner. If a leaf node, you know, leveled, if a leaf is leveled with epsilon, the nullable is true, definitely null will return true. Polar position will be 5. No, sorry, first position will be 5 because at, you know, you are at a leaf position, which is this. So here at the, you know, at this position, what string you can generate, that string can be only empty string. So what symbol is there at the beginning of the empty string, or at the first position of the empty string? You can't say. So you write 5. Okay, it is nullable. It is already nullable. So it is true. If a leaf position, if a leaf with position I, there is a leaf and it is having a position like this, like this, like this, then are they nullable? No, they are not nullable, so nullable will return false. And first position will be the I itself, because you are not thinking about the root or other part of the tree, you are thinking about only the leaf. So at that leaf itself, you can generate only that leaf symbol only. So it is only that I will be there. Now, an OR node you have, OR node N, which having two child, you know, C1, C2 left child and right child, okay, and C1 or C2 you have. Then nullable, how you will decide? You have to check both of them are nullable. Okay, if yes, left child is nullable and right child is also nullable, then you will say yes, it is nullable. And first position, you find out first position of the left child and first position of the right child, then you, you know, union, make them union and give that set in, you know, already inside. Then you will get the first position. Then if you have a cat node like this, then cat node gives you like this, the left child and right child are concatenated. That means your right child is always following the left child. So nullable, you have to check that left child is nullable, and here it is and, okay, and the right child is also nullable. If yes, then you can say it is, you know, nullable is true, otherwise it is false. Okay, and how will you find the first position? If the left child is nullable, then definitely the right child will get a chance to be, to come at the first position, right? So that will happen. So that is why, if nullable C1 and first position C1 and union first position of C2 is first position of C1 only. That means if it is not nullable, if this is C1, okay, and this is C2. Now if C1 is not nullable, then only in a first position of C1 will be the first position of this node. Understand? If for a star node, where, you know, there is a single child like this, you know, for the star node, if you see this is the only child under the star node, okay, so it is always true, nullable is always true, and first position is always this you know, first position of C1. Okay, so example, only the star node is nullable, that in case of nodes we understood that none of the leaves are nullable here in this example because they each correspond to some non-epsilon operands, and or node, you have or node here, you can see this one. Okay, or node is not nullable because neither of its child is nullable. So you can see it is having child, one child is this one, another child is this one, and they are not nullable. So this node is not nullable. Okay, the star node, if you see, is nullable because every star node is nullable, right? The star node, you can understand, the star means that it must have a string which it can generate is epsilon, so it is nullable. Okay, each of the cat node having at least one non-nullable child is not nullable. That means if you think about this cat node, have one child which is not nullable. That means what? This is also not nullable. But if both the child are nullable, then you can say this is also not nullable. Okay. For the OR node, we take the union of first position and the children and do the same for the last position. Okay, so here you can see first position N to left of the node N, and last position N is the is to its right. So on the left side, these are first position, and on the right side, these are last position. Okay, so these are last position. I am just marking with green color, you can understand. Okay, and these are the first positions. Okay. Each of the leaves has only itself for first position and last position. If you look at the leaves, these are the leaf nodes. So as we are at the leaf, so only one symbol is available there. So that symbol itself is the last position and the first position, right? But when you will come to the other intermediate nodes, then you can have the child, left child, right child. Based on that, you can think which will be the last position, which will become the first position and all. Okay. Now, consider the lowest cat node, which we shall call N. Okay, so this is the lowest cat node. Sorry, it's not lowest. It's cat node. This is not cat node. This is the lowest cat node. Okay, which we shall call as M. Okay, to compute first position of N, we first consider whether the left operand is nullable. Left operand means this is nullable, which it is in this case. Now, therefore, first pose for N is the union of first pose of each of its children. That means you can see here the left part is nullable, but it is having first position is 1 and 2, and right part, right operand is this, which is having first position there. Now, if left operand is nullable, that case, within union, the past position of the left part and past position of the right part. So here, sorry. So here we are calculating first position of aim, and the left operand is nullable, so we have to do union of first position of C1, so this is C1, and right part we are writing, giving as C2, union first position of C2. Okay, now first position of C1, if you see, it is given by this node actually. So you get 1 and 2 here. Okay, union first position of C2 is only 3 here. Okay, which is giving you 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so the rule for last position are the same as for first position with the children interchange. With the children interchange. That means to compute last position of aim, we must ask whether the right child is nullable, which is not in this case. This is the right child. C2 is the right child, right? It is not nullable. So what you will do, last position of n is the same as the last position of the right child. So what we are getting here, last position of n equal to last position of C2. Why? Because C2 is not nullable, okay, which is equal to 3. Understand? Now, computing follow position. Two ways that position of regular expression can be made to follow another. One is in A, if N is a cat node with left child C1 and right child C2, then every position I in last position C1 and the all position in first position of C2 are in follow position of I. You understand what it said? It said that if you see, if you look at this situation we had, star on, and here we had A, right? And here we had another cat node, B. Now, if we consider at this point, what it is saying that if in N, N is a cat node, so this is our N at this point, okay, with left child C1 and right child C2, then every position I in last position C1. So last position C1, what we found, go to the previous slide. No, sorry, yeah, last position of C1 is here, 1 and 2. So 1 and 2. So what it is saying that every position I, so this is given by I. So I equal to here 1 and 2. Okay. So every position I in last position C1 and then all position in first position C2. So what is C2? This is C2. What is first position of C2? It is only one is there, that is the 3. So position in the first position of C2 are in the follow position of I. Now if you say follow position of 1 If you calculate follow position of 2, what will be there? There will be 3. There will be 3. Clear? Now, if N is a star node like this, and I is a position in last position of N, okay? So now this is our N, and if I can remove these previous things, that will be better, I think. Okay, so what we had, if we had a star node, sorry, if we have a star node, and in the star node we had this A and B, right? And I is a position, the last position of N. So here we had last position of N 1 and 2. So this is N. So last position of N is we have 1 and 2. Okay. Then all position in first position of N are in follow position of I. So first you have to see what? First position of N. First position of N is what? 1 and 2. So it is saying that all position in the first position of N will be in the follow position of these elements 1 equal to 2. In this case, it is like this. Okay. Now, rule one for follow position requires that we look at each cat node and put each position in first pose of its right child in the follow position for each position in last position of its left child. So this is what we have already practiced. Then, for lowest cat node, we have a lowest cat node here. That rule says position 3 is in follow 1 and follow position 2. The next cat node says that 4 is in follow position 3, and remaining two cat nodes give us that 5. What is 5? This 5 is in follow position of 4 and 6 is in follow position of 5. So here is the node and here is the follow position, you can check out. Okay. Now, directed graph for the function follow position. You see here, that means who is following what. If you use them to draw a graph, then what will happen? If you see, we have 1 and 2. If you keep first 1 and 2 and 3, that and we what we'll do it from say 1 we take first, okay. Okay, take one first. Okay, if there is a position in follow position, this part, we will make a transition to that position. Okay, so one itself is there, so make a transition for one. Then instead of doing it, it is already there. So one itself is there, so have a self transition, and two is there, so take another state two, you can go there, right? Then three is there, so from one to three you can come here. Okay, then you look at two, from two you can go to one because this one is here. Then two is also here in the follow position, so have a self loop here. Okay, then three is also there, so two to three you can go. Then at three, follow position is four, so it is a new state, you go to four. At four, your follow position is five, you can go to five. And at five, your follow position is six, you can go to six. And your sixth follow position is five, there is nothing, so there is no follow position for six. You don't go anywhere, okay? Clear?